The promise of Azure IoT Central in combination with IoT Plug-and-Play is to make IoT simple. Sandeep from the IoT Solutions team is here to demo us exactly what that means in a matter of minutes. Hi, everyone. This is the Internet of Things show. I'm Olivier, your host, and today with Sandeep. We want to talk about this magic that IoT Plug-and-Play and IoT Central will bring to simplify IoT, correct?
Absolutely.
Before diving into a demo that will be short because it's magic.
That's right.
Sandeep, do you mind introducing yourself real quick and what your team is doing?
Sure. Again, my name is Sandeep Pujar. I'm a program manager on the Azure IoT team, specifically IoT Solutions, and mostly focusing on IoT Central. And I work on device connectivity, device provisioning, modeling, and PNP is one of the key things there.
Awesome. So we've been announcing IoT Plug-and-Play, which the promise is basically, the way I like to present is the USB for IoT devices, mm-hmm. right? You mm-hmm. plug, and the machine, the application will discover what this device can do and be able to understand the messages and interact with that device.
That's true. So let me give you like a before and after of this whole thing, right? So that you can actually clearly
Perfect.
Sort of distinguish between the two. So today, if you go to IoT Central, you would have to connect a real device. What you'd have to do is you would have to go create a device template right? So again, you have to hand author it, sort of add these telemetry elements mm-hmm. or states and events and commands. So, and then once you have defined the shape of the device, you'd have to work with your OEM partners or device partners so that they can build that on the device, right?
And make sure that the device is actually sending the right format and things like that.
Absolutely. Yep. And then there's a lot of back and forth that you're making sure that the actual element that you're sending mm-hmm. is what is configured on the cloud and things like that.
To be fair, it's already a big advance compared to the DIY version of that, right?
Absolutely. So IoT Central already is kind of a step ahead of that.
Yep.
And what we have done with Plug and Play is like taking the story much more further, right?
Okay.
Again, I mean, if you sort of thought of IoT Central as making IoT simple on the cloud side of things, IoT Plug and Play is going to make it simple from cloud to device side of things as well.
Yep.
So it's an end-to-end simplification that you
okay.
can see. So that was the first step, right? Once you have sort of done that, then you would come into IoT Central, configure your device, and then connect the device. And once the device connects, the operator will have to associate that to a specific template, and then you will see the device sort of sending data and sort of.
Got it. There was no magic that would say, hey, this is that template, whatever. Device just comes up and you have to manually say, this one is that template.
As I said, it's still a long step forward. Again, with PNP, what we do is like we cut all of these steps out.
Yes.
And essentially you have one step, meaning if you have an Azure certified PNP device, you connect that device to IoT Central, and it just works. You get a default dashboard, and then you will see the telemetry, every other aspect of the device just show up, and the experience is ready to use.
Love
it. Again, what we have done here is like, A, you have sort of a common language that we use, the DTDL language, so the OEMs can go ahead and then build their software against that for a standard interface. And we also sort of automated the whole discovery of the model process so that once the device connects, Central will basically go fetch the right model for the device and puts the experience up.
So all that experience that we promised when we announced Plug and Play, what you're telling me is that you're going to demo that because it's today available in IoT Central.
That's right. So as you rightly called out, we had announced this back in build, and now we are ready for public preview.
Okay.
And there's sort of experience on IoT Central. There's a bunch of other documentation on the rest of the things as well.
Let's jump in it.
All right.
Let's do it.
I'll walk through a couple of new features again on Central, and then also sort of we'll get into the specifics of what the plug and play promises, right? Uh-huh. So what you see here is a new plug and play preview app. Or a preview app on IoT Central with all the new features. Again, Plug and Play being one of the primary ones, right? So I just created this app. If you go down here, there are no devices in here, so it's all empty. So, and if I go to device templates here, again, it's all empty, so there's nothing here, right? So as we were talking about, the promise is when I connect a device which is PNP certified, you should see a device automatically show up here under devices.
Okay.
And then it should have also fetched the right model for it, and we should see the device template show up here.
Got it.
Right? So all of that just when I connect the device.
That's the promise.
Right. Excellent. So what I have here is I have an MX chip device, which is one of the things which I have sort of worked mostly to get the software of it as well, part of it as well, and also it's a PNP certified device. Okay. So we will use that for our demo today.
Okay. So
let's go ahead and what I've done is I've already configured the device with the right credentials.
Meaning
if you were to go to the administration section here, right? And if you go to the device connection part, right? So you have the scope ID. And you have the primary key to use to connect the device. So what I've done is I've already published that or put that on the device. So that once I connect the device, it'll just show up on this, app.
And a reminder for people, that section is about the provisioning process for devices to auto-provision themselves into the Iot Central application.
That's accurate. So so what you just now saw was I just plugged out the device and sort of plugged back in. Now you see the device show up already on under devices.
Actually, yes. We just you didn't switch tab one up. Right. Awesome.
Cool.
Magic.
So that's the magic.
That's the magic.
So once you so now you have a device
that's
automatically out there.
Yep.
And then
if you click on it.
If you click on the device, you should have a default experience that shows up with data.
And there's a dashboard that's been created, and
Yeah, and there's a default dashboard that shows up there, and a bunch of data already you can see, right?
Okay.
And if you go down to device templates, the device template is already there.
Okay.
Right? So the
if you go into that device template, what do you see there? We see the actual telemetry fields, and everything has been populated in there.
Absolutely. So if you go to the device template field, you'll see the device capability model, which we have fetched from the global repo of certified devices.
And that's new.
That's new. And that is the whole auto-discovery process I was talking about earlier.
Yeah.
So you sort of you fetched all of that, it's all published, and the device connector is ready to go.
Got it.
Now let's imagine I want to go back and change something in the view, right?
The
view section is also new in the new preview
app.
If you remember the previous app, we had a standard set of tabs like measurements and settings and properties and so on. What we have done is we have kind of given a lot more flexibility to our customers and not prescribe a standard set of tabs. So that they can optimize the experience based on their device, right?
It's basically based on demands from customers using the solution.
Absolutely. Okay. I mean, if you think of it, not all devices are equal. And every device will have its own optimized experience. So you would basically want to enable that, right? So so now by default, we have created a few tiles and dashboards here. Let's say I want to go back and go and edit some of them, right? Like let's say I don't want some of the tiles that that don't make sense to me. So I just go and remove them.
Okay.
And I can quickly go publish the experience, and then now that experience is available and it's reflected on the device, right? So now what I do is I did this, I go save, and I quickly publish the changes.
Okay.
And you'll see that the device views will change based on that quick fix there, right? So if you look at this, we've removed these tiles out here, and then this basically demonstrates the flexibility from a solution builder's point of view so that they can go and optimize the experiences fairly quickly, right? So I'll show one more thing, which is, so now we have this device template. Let's say I have a certain settings or certain sort of properties I want to change on the device, right?
Okay.
So as you see, this particular device has a few settings. Again, this is the view for putting together a form of sorts so that you can do a cloud to device message.
Okay.
Or if you're familiar with settings in the in the previous version, this is sort of a similar thing there, right? So let me sort of go ahead and add a few properties to this. I'll add a fan speed so that we can change the fan speed on the device. And
don't need to save before or something.
So you have this one, you just added the fan speed, you saved it.
And so these are actually extracted from the device capability model, right?
That's absolutely right. Yeah, so the device capability model you see here will have one of those capabilities that show up there. So ready to go, we publish again this new form.
New view,
new form, and if you go to the device now and
it applies to all the devices of that type.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So now you have this new form here.
Okay.
That shows up,
right? Yeah. And in there you can actually change the fan speed.
Okay. Absolutely. Yeah. So now I'm going to go change the fan speed. Mm-hmm. So you should see on the device that the fan speed changes.
Okay. Right?
So I'm going to change it, let's say, to 100.
Yep.
And you should very soon see it reflect on the device.
Okay.
There you go.
Yep, I can see it.
So yeah,
yep,
got a fancy span spinning there. So all of that, again, as I said, is new with all the flexibility that we provide, both mm-hmm. from the device connectivity point of view and also from the visualization point of view.
And what I'm seeing is actually the plug-and-play model is becoming what's actually powering some of IoT Central in terms of understanding the device, interacting with it, right? So previously, we have this notion of properties and parameters and whatever that were actually proper to IoT Central.
Yep.
Now, this has been totally replaced by plug-and-play model.
Absolutely, absolutely. Okay. And that is, in fact, that is one of the biggest changes you'll see. I mean, what that means is every certified device, PNP certified mm-hmm. device that goes into catalog will automatically work with Central.
Okay.
So that's
existing devices connecting to today's version of IoT Central, will they be able to connect to that new version of IoT Central?
Absolutely.
Okay.
So existing devices will and can continue to sort of work with the new version. Mm-hmm. As we initially kind of pointed out, IoT Central was already in that journey of PNP and language standardization kind of a thing. And basically this enables that experience.
Love it.
So that is the experience of IoT Central and plug-and-play.
I like that. I want to show a bit more about the scenario of you connected a device that was just there. Magically, Central went and fetched somewhere this model, right? So the device declared itself as, I'm of that type of model.
Yeah.
Here's where to find it. Or is there a public catalog? Or how does it work?
Good question. So right now, every PNP certified device, if they go through the certification pipeline, mm-hmm. The device capability models for those devices are in a global repository of sorts maintained by Microsoft.
Right? Okay.
So they are there. So once the device connects, it basically says that I am of this device type or this model ID, mm-hmm. and that is what we will use to go fetch that, or Central will use to go fetch that from that global repo.
Got it. So using that ID from that device, goes to the Central repo,
gets
that model, and runs.
Yeah.
So now if I want to prepare my application and I don't have a device yet, how does that work?
That's a good point. So that again brings up the other interesting integration we have done with IoT Central, mm-hmm. right? So if you go to the device template section, and I'm a solution builder here, and I'm looking to sort of build a solution for, let's say, an asset tracker solution, right? So that's what we've used in our mm-hmm. previous experience as well. So what you will see is you will see that the Azure IoT device catalog is now automatically or integrated with IoT Central.
It just shows up there.
It just shows up there.
So
what I did was I went to device templates, I hit new, mm-hmm. and along with the custom device templates or device DCMs mm-hmm. I can add, I can also pick from the certified devices, right? Like MX chip is one, that's what we use just now. And if you can pick any of the pre-certified PNP devices and then get going. Like, let's say if we pick one of them here, you automatically create a device template for it. And then as you saw, we also create default views for it. So off the bat, you can get a device that's already certified and sort of start building solutions for it, and then get the real device and connect it, and you should just get the experience up.
So the default view actually has been published as part of the model on the catalog, right? By the device manufacturer.
That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
So as device manufacturers, right, people should understand that once they certify their device, anyone building an IoT Central app will see it pop up there in the device templates collection.
That's absolutely true. And that's that's the power for OEMs to sort of surface their certified devices. And from the solution builder's point of view, now they have a range of devices they can pick from all these OEMs and in all in one place. So it's sort of getting the right sort of people on the same pane so that they can work together.
Fantastic.
So that's the idea.
That's the idea. Well, actually the promise, and in a few minutes, in about 10 minutes, we ran through the concepts.
Yep.
And then through the actual demo of everything, the device connecting on its own was kind of magic.
Yep.
The device manufacturers has still to work on the code in there, right?
That's true.
And on that side, plug and play comes with SDKs and documentation.
Yep.
So actually, it's not like you're on your own. You actually leverage the SDKs or the extension to the device SDKs to build you know, the connectivity and the fact that the device will publish its model and then implement things correctly in terms of telemetry format and device methods and so forth.
That's right. That's right. And all of that is available for as part of public preview for OEM partners to look at and build and certify their devices, and for the solution builders to go look at all these devices and build their solutions.
Okay. Well, people know what I have to do. If you want to learn more, you go to aka.ms/IoTshow/IoTPNP, like plug and play.
Yep.
So that you're going to have more information and so forth. Otherwise, go check out the preview of the IoT Central new device template or template, sorry, app template that supports plug and play. Sandeep, thanks for that overview. Thanks for that short demo. Awesome. Looking forward to see all the rest that is coming into IoT Central.
Thank you so much. Exciting to be here.
Thanks, guys, for watching the IoT Show. See you soon.
Thank you.